Let me graph some piecewise defined functions to show you how this works. This example is similar to one that's in the text and also in WebAssign. So the function is defined first of all as f of x is equal to x squared minus 1 if negative 2 is less than or equal to x is less than 1. And then in the second piece, it's 4 over x if 1 is less than or equal to x is less than 4. So to begin with, let's do that first section. Now, we know what the graph of x squared should look like because that was one of the parent functions, one of those 8 functions that we had to learn. So it's going to be a parabola, which looks like this. However, we've got a negative 1 added in here, so what that does to this graph is it actually moves it down 1 unit. So it's going to take this and move it down along the vertical axis 1 unit. So let's start with the endpoint values for it and see where they are. So at negative 2, if I just make a little T diagram here and calculate these ordered pairs, at negative 2, we have negative 2 squared minus 1. And so that's going to give us positive 4 minus 1, which will be 3. So our first value here will be at a negative 2, 3. And that is a closed endpoint because we have the inequality that includes the negative 2. Okay, so let's do the other endpoint, which is 1. And at that I have 1 squared minus 1, which gives us 0. Okay, and that endpoint is open. So if I were to graph these, the first ordered pair goes from negative 2, 3. So we'll go out negative 2 and up 3. And that's closed, so we're here. The second endpoint is at 1, 0, so that's right here as a x-intercept, and that one, oops, is open. Okay, well that's quite a spread in here. We do know that it should be a parabola shape, but let's get some points in between. So let's try, how about negative 1? So at negative 1, we're squaring that and subtracting 1. So we have 1 minus 1, which is 0. So at negative 1, we're also at an x-intercept. And let's try 0. So at 0 squared minus 1, we're at negative 1. So there's actually the vertex of that parabola, which we'll learn more about in chapter 9. But there's the horseshoe shape, which we're expecting. If this were the whole graph with no restriction here, it would go with this shape, the kind of the bucket or the horseshoe shape. But for here, it's going from negative 2, 3 down to the first x-intercept, down to the y-intercept, and back up to the x-intercept in that fashion. Okay. So there's the first portion. Now the second portion is also like one of the parent graphs that we were doing. And so when we had the graph of f of x as 1 over x, we know that that looked like the graph of a hyperbola, where in the first quadrant we have the one little part of the hyperbola and the second part goes like this. So we're looking at a section here in the first quadrant. So let's graph it and see how it fits with this shape here. So let me do a T diagram again for x and 4 over x. And so at 1, we have 4 over 1, or we're at 4. And that first endpoint is closed because it's included with the equal sign there in that less than or equal to x. The second endpoint is a value of 4, so at 4, we put 4 over 4, so it's equal to 1. And that endpoint is open because it's a strict inequality for x being less than 4. So we'll start with 1, 4, and we're up here. At 1, we go up 4 units. 1, 2, 3, 4, way up here. And that's closed. And then down here at 4, I'm out 1 unit, or up 1 unit. 1, 2, 3, 4, I'm up 1 unit, and that endpoint is open. Again, we're expecting it to have a curve, a slight curve like in this graph up here from the parent function, but it's too much of a spread here, so we need to get some points in between. So let's try at 2, we have 4 over 2, so excuse me, we have, I should reverse that. That's correct. We have 4 over 2, so we're at 2. So at 2, I'm up 2. And let's squeeze it in here at 3. I'm going to be at 4 over 3, or 1 and a third. So at 3, I go up 1 and then a third. And let's try a value up here and see what we get. At 1.5, that's 3/2. And so I would get here 4 over 3/2. And use your calculator if it bothers you doing this, but remember that invert the denominator and change it to a multiplication. So this would be 4 times 2 over 3, or 8/3. Now 8/3 is, let's see, it's 2, and what do I got? 2/3. So I'm going to go over here at 3/2, 1.5. I'm going to go up 3/3, 6/3, 7/3, 8/3, right up there. So there's where I go. And there's that portion of the graph. Now, to be complete, I should label these endpoints here. So this first one was at -2. I was up 3 units. And down here, let me label this one because it's a nice turning point at 0. I'm down -1. And up here at, I'm at the end 1, I was at 0. And then going up here at 1, I was at 4. And over here at 4, I was at 1. Okay, and there's the graph. Clearly label your endpoints as to open or close, so that anybody looking at it will understand what, if it's included or not. Now the second example just continues this type of problem. And I have f of x is negative x squared from a negative 2 to 0, and the square root of x. And again, these are just parts of the parent functions that we've looked at. So this one, again, we're expecting that to be a parabola shape, but the negative sign in front of the x squared is actually going to flip it. Okay, so we're going to expect that to look like a downward parabola. And let's actually graph it by looking at some ordered pairs. So we'll go from x and negative x squared. Okay, so the first endpoint is at negative 2, and I want the opposite of a negative 2 squared. So that's going to give us the opposite of a positive 4. So we're going to be at negative 4. And the endpoint there is included, so it's closed. And then going to the other endpoint at 0, so we have a 0. And we're going to take the opposite of 0 squared, which is just 0, because 0 has no sign. And this endpoint, if you look at the inequality, it's going to be open. So again, now at negative 2, we're down negative 4. And let me just go down, negative 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, down here, and that one's closed. And then at the origin, I am at 0, 0, and that one is open. Oops, I keep wanting to close these, but that's open. Okay, so we expect this to be a parabola section. So, but again, to get the curvature, we should do some ordered pairs. So let me go at negative 1. So that'll be the opposite of a negative 1 squared. So we're at negative 1. And how about between negative 1 and negative 2, let's do negative, 3/2. So we have the opposite of a negative 3/2 squared. So that'll be a negative 9/4. Okay, so that's 2 1/4. So at negative 3/2, I'm going to go down negative 4/4, negative 8/4, negative 9/4, which is add a little fourth here. Okay, and then back up here, I'm at negative 1, negative 1. So you can kind of start getting the curvature in here. Okay. And there's that section, beginning with a closed endpoint at negative 2, negative 4, and an open endpoint at the origin. Now the next section is a square root function. and it goes from 0 to 4 with both endpoints being open. The square root function is one of those parent functions that we need to know, and so we know that that is like a half of a parabola on its side. That was the square root of x from one of those eight functions, and that's what we're expecting. To get the exact ordered pairs, let's just do a T diagram. We'll start with the first endpoint, which is 0, and square root of 0 is 0. So again, we start at the origin, but this endpoint is open. And let's go to the endpoint of 4. Square root of 4 is the nice clean value of 2, and that endpoint is also open. Okay, so at the origin, we have an open endpoint, and out here at 4, we're up 2 units, and it's an open endpoint. Let's make it open. Okay, but again, between, you don't want to draw a straight line, you want some curvature, so we better get some ordered pairs in there. So at 1, square root of 1 is giving us 1, and at 2, the square root of 2, well, use your calculator if you don't know what that is. So square root of 2 has a decimal approximation of about 1.4. And for 3, the square root of 3 we know is about 1.7. You could check it out on your calculator too. And it's about 1.73, but we're not going to get that close. We're just going to use 1.7. So I go out here and I need to pass through 1, 1. And at 2, I need to go up about 1.4. And at 3, I need to go up about 1.7. So you can see the gradual curve there over 2, 4, 2. And so there's that second graph. Okay, the third graph uses one of our parent functions again, the absolute value of x. Now remember, this was the v-type function. Okay, and this has a negative sign in front, so instead of the v-type function being like this, we're going to expect it to be flipped. And that would be if there were no restrictions on this domain, but this domain starts from a negative 1 and goes to negative infinity. Now this problem's a little different in that the one section, the beginning and the end section of this graph are infinite, so there's going to be a half line for this first section and a half line for the second section, which we'll show by arrowing the part of our line that goes towards the infinity. So the first section there, let me just do some ordered pairs. So let's see, I'll start with x being less than negative 1. So I'm going to start at the endpoint for negative 1, and the absolute value there of a negative of, the absolute value of a negative 1 comes out to be, well, this is a positive 1, and then I want a negative sign in front, so it's a negative 1. Now, this continues to negative infinity, so we have at negative 2, we want the opposite of the absolute value of a negative 2, so we're at negative 2. At negative 3, we want the opposite of the absolute value of a negative 3, so we're at negative 3, and so on. Okay, so the first endpoint, the only endpoint, is open. So we start with that at negative 1, with an open endpoint, and we go through negative 2, negative 2, negative 3, negative 3, and so on. And there's where our line goes. And use a ruler with your graphing. Makes it nice and neat. And in this case, we want the arrow on the end of the first half line heading towards negative infinity, because this was x is anything smaller than a negative 1. And let me label the endpoint. And there's the first section. Now the second section is just the horizontal line, y equals 2, and it goes between a negative 1 and positive 2. So if I were to graph that, everything here for your y value is just going to be 2. So the starting value is at negative 1, and that endpoint is closed because of the equal sign here with the x. The other endpoint is going to be open. So at the endpoint of 2, it's open. And let's put a 0 in between. Okay, notice that everything here for the y value is 2 because this is a horizontal line. So I'll start from negative 1, 2, and close it. And then I go through 0, 2, and I go over to 2, 2 with an open endpoint. And there's my horizontal line. And that's that graph. Now the last section in there is just an ordinary line, and we're going to have a half line here. Okay, if you've borne with me this part of the YouTube, I'll give you extra credit in my class if you email me the name of the video and the name of my dog. And my dog's name is Nika, N-I-K-A. Okay, so email that to me, and I'll give you 2 points for watching this. So continuing on with this section as the last piece of this piecewise defined function, let's do the ordered pairs for that. And so at x, we want y to be negative 2x plus 3. So the starting value here is for 2 and anything greater than 2. And this is going to be a closed endpoint. So I'll start with 2 and make the note that it's going to be closed. So plugging it in, I get negative 2 times 2 plus 3, which is equal to negative 4 plus 3 is equal to a negative 1. So at 2, negative 1, I have a closed endpoint. Now you could go from this moving down by the slope, because the slope, remember, is the coefficient of the x term, so it has a slope of a negative 2, but I'm just going to get some more ordered pairs in here to give a nice sequence. So at 3, I have negative 2 times 3 plus 3. So that's negative 6 plus 3, which is a negative 3. And at 4, I have negative 2 times 4 plus 3, which is negative 8 plus 3. What is that going to give me? That's going to give me a negative 5. Okay, so at 3, I want to be down 3. And at 4, I want to be down 5. Okay, and so on. And so I could use the slope here and get another point down here. Again, use a ruler if you have one. If you don't, use what I'm doing, just make shift. Oops, a little bit off there. And this has an arrow on the end because this last portion of the piece is infinite, okay? X can be anything greater than 2. So label these endpoints. This was 2, negative 1. And there's the third section of this graph. And I'll go back up here to be complete and label this. This was negative 1, 2. And this one over here was 2, 2. Okay, and there's the graph of this piecewise defined function.